Welcome to St. Thomas More. Today's Mass intentions are for Jerry Korsman. And as you're silencing your cell phones, our opening song is number 502, Take Up Our Cross.
Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, God would cause the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose. Grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Jesus went to the beach, says the writer of the Bible, and he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." Then he strictly ordered his disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Seeds that is protected and shaded, and over time it grows to become the largest so that it then shades and protects. It's the image that is given to us. But we have to learn that oftentimes we can only learn whenever we let ourselves be subject to authority. Someone sent to us, someone who knows, someone who is experienced most of the time, someone who knows what is good and true and real, someone who has been vetted and sent into a position for a particular purpose, to help. I gave the last mass example of a dentist, and I stepped right in because there were three dentists right over there as I said it. But I gave the example of the dentist. Like, you walk into a doctor's office and a dentist, and you look over, and there's, this is good, it's building up dentists. But you look over, and there's the certificates, like, oh, I am certified with this, and certified by this board, and certified with all these different pieces. And so you look, and you feel good, okay, good, I'm in good hands. Someone has validated, vetted, given them authority to do what they're doing. But what if you were to walk in and to the dentist's office, and you begin to realize that you're even, I'm certified in creating firecrackers, blowing things up, fixing bombs. I mean, if you say, oh, that's really cool, what does that have to do with dentistry? And he's like, all right, open up. How would that make you feel? Is that proper? Are they vetted? Have they been given authorities to work on my teeth or just to blow teeth up? What is it? Why is that not right? And so, as we begin, someone may have the power to do such things, but that person has not been given authority. And the thing is, in our life, we have to begin to distinguish between what is power and what is authority. It's an interesting question. You might have never thought of it before. What's the difference between power and authority? I may decide that, you know what, for boobs and giggles, I want to send a missile and blow up some penguin to the Arctic or send it to the ocean. I don't know, whatever. And I may sign an executive order and send it off to NORAD. Do what I want to do. And they're just going to rip it up and throw it away because who's probably waiting? I don't know this cat. It's crazy. Whatever. I'm not going to work. I don't have the authority for that. Nor do I have the power. But I don't have the authority. Only the president has that authority. Now, if we were to gather our full forces of USC students and go to NORAD and take our keys and shoot that missile off into space for fun or that penguin, whatever it is, then by power, I have exerted my force of will over to get what I want. I might not have the authority to do such things, but I have accrued the power to be able to do it. There's a distinction between what is power and what is authentic authority. In our lives, we have to learn not to conflate these two. We should react poorly to power, especially power that is improperly used, but not of proper authority. When a parent asks us in their own home to clean our room or to wash or do whatever, I don't know, brush your teeth, pick one. It always comes back to teeth, whatever. It is within their rights. It is within their authority to ask such things. And we should comply. And something inside of us knows it. There's something inside of us when somebody with legit authority asks us to do something, we're like, there's part of us that knows what's going on. Or you're going down the road doing 60 and 50, and bless his heart, that cop pulls you over. He is within his authority, properly done, to come over and get one ticket. You may bless his heart all day long, but it's within his rights, his proper authority. Guidelines, the church, COVID, the university, rules. They are the proper authorities. It is within their jurisdiction and rights and their spaces to ask you to do what needs to be done in order to protect, to do something that is good and right. And these are things that we have to acknowledge and acquiesce to. When someone forces us to do something that we don't want to do without the proper authority or that is against the good, we know that it is against our own conscience through some use of power, then we naturally resist. Just because and that might doesn't always make right, as we often hear. Now, full circle. Jesus today gives under his authority, thanks to faith and morals, he has the power to make decisions, for it to be binding. It has teeth. When I came here, the bishop gave me the keys to St. Thomas More. And so I thought about it last night, so I was like, well, actually, Pam gave me the keys. But the bishop was the one who told me to do it. It is what it is. But at the end of the day, he's the one who had given that authority to come and make the best decisions I can for the mission of those who are here as a part of his flock. In the local church, we have a source of authority. Our bishop, the successor of the apostles, through the laying on of hands. And where he can't be, his priests are in his stead. And the deacons who are there with him to serve the bishop, or the bishop is not to serve the people of God, and to attend and help the priest in the mission. In the universal church, there is authority. The first among the bishops is the successor of Peter. He has the authority to use when it is needed. Which oftentimes, when it comes to things of faith and morals, is very rare. Administration, yes. But when it comes to times of faith and morals, it's very rarely used in this. But we know who has the big wolf stick. We know, at the end of the day, where the buck stops. We are called to honor that. It's a safeguard for the faith. It's not a weapon to be wielded, but it's a shield to guard and steward the flock. All those in positions of leadership have to always be very cognizant of this. Whether you are an older sibling, whether you are a parent, whether you're in positions of leadership, whether it's your work and you have people under you, whether it's you just have people watching you because they look up to you, everyone has to be always very cognizant to remember this mission to the other when one is in a position of authority, to set the example. And the key to that, the key to obedience, is humility. Giving of oneself, making oneself last, as we talked about the last few weeks. And the key to having an unassuming authority is service. Because it's not pointed at gain. This isn't about me. This isn't about me taking what I want. Authority is about the other. You have been given charge of something, of someone, to be the example. And so you are to order yourself to the other. That's why they always put those words around it. Servant leadership. It's not just leadership for our own gain. It's leadership for the good of the other. Any parent knows it. Any boss is learning. It's not about you. It's about who you were sent to help. So authority is given to us to guide, guard, protect. So for each and every one of us, let us ask to first be obedient, whatever is necessary from us. And let us also learn servants, so that we are sent to serve each other and not to serve ourselves. Together as one family, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father and the Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only God, the Son of God. Amen. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Like Peter, may we recognize and trust that you will hear the prayers we offer in faith.
For the church, that her leaders and members be mindful of serving the world with humility and faith, we pray. For world leaders, may they place the needs and rights of the oppressed before those who are revered in society. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church, against which the gates of death cannot prevail, will work with confidence to eradicate the injustices of abortion, infanticide, and euthanasia. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our young people, may they be blessed with a safe, peaceful transition back to school. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have gone before us, may they find joy and honor as they enter into eternal peace with the righteous. Especially we remember Jerry Corson. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of infinite love and wisdom, we humbly ask you to hear these prayers. Continue to keep us faithful to the humility of Christ, so that we may one day rejoice in the resurrection of the righteous. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and the Almighty Father. A people by adoption, through the one sacrifice offered once for all. Bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church, through Christ and our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we acclaim. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Thomas More, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. And your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty God, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
bleeds within us, O Lord, we pray the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I ask you to just take a seat for one more minute. As new students and new faces continue to come, last week and this week, we just want to make sure we could introduce two of our new leaders to you.
Southern dismissal, I think I've never seen or heard. It was great. It was perfect. I love it.
to it. If you ever have any questions about any of this, definitely call the bulletin. The bulletin gets better every week, so they're really doing a good job with that. If you ever have something you think needs to be in the bulletin, or we need to spread the word about something, email us. Email Kelly. If you have to, email me. Email Kelly. We'll kind of get it there and do what we need to do. We'll see you here for those of you who want to come back to the 5 p.m. For the students. We have to encourage it. This is our test. So I'm going to give it to the 5 p.m. So this is our test to see how well we can interact as students here on campus. So there's a lot of people watching to see how group activities go. So obedience. Prayerful and obedience. We ask that you just follow the rules as we do it to have fun, get to know each other, and safely. Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. May do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.